How's it going, everybody? Welcome to a brand new episode of Crypto Clout. I am your host, FaZe Crypto, and today we are talking about Cardano. The date is May 8th, 2019. And starting off the video, we have this article right here. Cardano founder hits that when crypto will be ready for institutional money. The Cardano founder, Charles Hodgkinson, says the current crypto ecosystem is not ready for institutional money to enter the space. And he thinks it will take another 12 to 24 months before it is, according to a report, which I suppose will give us plenty of times to fill up our bags and basically be prepared for when that institutional money finally does hit. But I think that if any founder is going to be an authority on this subject, Charles certainly is one of those people that I do listen to from time to time regarding these different things. And this is coming at an interesting time. We've got Cardano revamps the marketing strategy, subreddit and Twitter channels grow massively, and Cardano subreddit grows 200K to 400K in less than 2 months. A Cardano brand awareness on the rise on Twitter and other social platforms following the internal resurrection, reconstruction, and all those different things. Cardano has from its inception kept a small marketing profile compared to other crypto projects like Tron. Several bodies have been in charge of Cardano's marketing over the years, including IOHK, Emergo, and Cardano Foundation. However, the primary responsibility for the Cardano Foundation is to market the network. And I think that looking at these different articles, it is interesting to see. I mean, because of course I am participating in the Cardano social media landscape by making this video, so it is pretty interesting to see these different moves that are happening. And of course we've got a similar article to the related marketing momentum that has basically been hitting the scene regarding Cardano in this short amount of time, which I suppose is pretty interesting to see how basically this crypto is getting a lot of the attention that it deserves, which I think it's good that Cardano is not going unnoticed. The project is operated with a relatively small marketing profile, yada yada. But the interesting thing that separates this one right here is it actually has the engagement, which I found pretty interesting, just to see the data, and of course making mention of the Cardano roadmap overhaul, which we've been talking about pretty extensively on this channel, which is of course interesting to see. I think of course with Shelley and a lot of these different aspects of this growing dynamic, I think it's something that's certainly worthy of paying attention to. We've got on this article unhacked the trade recommendation here too, which is just sort of an interesting little bit of information. I mean, the fact that Cardano has been getting this kind of publicity definitely does go a good way in the direction of basically establishing the overall recognizability of these things. But then again, we've also got at the time of making this video, of course, May 8th, we've got Bitcoin at 5,930, which is pretty cool. The fact that Bitcoin's been able to maintain itself at those levels definitely does show something in the line of how it's been able to basically overcome a lot of the stigma, I think, that existed around that $3,000 level. Of course, we're nowhere near where we're hoping to go. Of course, if anything, that Charles has been saying, the 12 to 24 months idea goes into any of this. It definitely still is interesting, the fact that, that 6,000 might be right around the corner. Who knows? But still, at the same time, I think it is very interesting to see, just exactly how the space has been able to make these developments, which have been going, I think, pretty far. Of course, when we look at something like Bitcoin and of course Ethereum, and the whole idea of smart contracts and that basically cryptocurrency making that jump into a whole new conversation, which I think is really starting to develop in a big way, which of course definitely does bring Cardano to the conversation, to the table, the number 10 crypto of course, at the time making this video. And of course, we've got the market cap at 185,621. Now, of course, BTC dominance at 56.5%. Always interesting to see the top performer at any given time in making these videos. I think it's been a pretty good archive that we've been developing, just of looking at what the top performers are at any given moment. BitTorrent, NEXT, Maxamine, Project Pay. Pretty interesting to see, Orbs and Electronium, Tron, Decentraland, pretty interesting stuff just to get an idea of who the top performers are. But then again, we've got this article right here, Max Cure on Reorg, BTC rejected, stupidity. So, it's pretty interesting narrative, I think, worth of us, looking at. Today brought news that Binance, the world's largest crypto exchange, had undergone a serious security breach with hackers managing to successfully abscond with over 7K BTC in user funds. That followed was claim that, it's interesting. I'm sure you guys are already well aware of this. I mean, this video is not going to spend too much time talking about it, but I think that, just giving it that second, I mean, it is an interesting, thing that I've been paying attention to. Probably we'll talk about during the live stream, but, in the same vein, I think that it is interesting just to look at, all these different things, how they've been, basically developing, and, the events that have been taking place. But, we've got, Forbes, BT, Facebook's Bitcoin rival gets big, institutions keen on crypto, which is, of course, a pretty interesting step towards massive adoption in this space, which I think is something that, that really does go a long way in terms of just how we've been seeing a lot of these different developments taking place. We're not the only ones who are paying attention to, crypto and all these different things as they've been developing. And I think, it definitely does say a lot, when we've been seeing these moves that have been being made by the institutions and, in particular Facebook, with how many eyes are paying attention to something as big as, a movement towards cryptocurrency that we could be, seeing in the near future, which is, of course, pretty interesting to say the least. And of course, just looking at this chart right here is something pretty interesting as well. Definitely exciting to see. I think in the future we could be expecting to see some pretty exciting things with Cardano, and I'm pretty excited, just to see exactly how it's going to look. Watching a lot of these different things get ironed out. It is history in the making, and I think the cryptocurrency world is going to be pretty. Pretty interesting to pay attention to over the next year or so, 12 months, 24 months. But, PayPal skips Bitcoin while clearly working on blockchain. I think that this is just par for the course, but it is definitely interesting. We've got, PayPal doesn't want to miss out on blockchain and crypto revolution. These big companies are paying attention to what's happening with crypto. I think that's sort of a running theme that we see happening. And I think as Facebook and all these different entities start running into a lot of these different problems, we will eventually basically see the solution. And I think on the horizon, it's already being identified by many as the blockchain revolution, all these different things. PayPal's CEO is not alone in the company's top management ranks with regard to Bitcoin skepticism. The firm's CEO, Dan, earlier this year took a swipe at Bitcoin, saying, "We're not seeing many retailers at all accept cryptocurrencies." But I think that that's only a matter of time, and I think that they're all aware of the capacity for things to change and evolve. But all that being said, I think Cardano could be very much at the front of a lot of these different things, and all the power of that, you know, is at people's fingertips with smart devices, and you know how many businesses have already been forced to essentially incorporate iPads and be little more than app functioners, you know, at specific locations. But I mean, I suppose that's another issue for a different time. We'll explore later on. But you know, with the attention of people like Elon Musk and stuff like that, I think crypto is certainly going somewhere from here. But all that being said, I mean, this video has been for entertainment, educational purposes only. I hope that you guys have enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next one. And now, of course, remember, this video is not financial advice. Of course, I'm not your dad. But all that being said, make sure that you guys subscribe and connect with us on Twitter. That's at CryptoTuber, as always. And I hope that you guys have enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good one.